In this video, I'll be discussing the special cases of infeasibility, alternative or multiple optimal solutions, unboundedness, and degeneracy in simplex method. Let's begin with infeasibility, which essentially means there is no feasible solution. As seen in the graph for this model here, there is no region satisfying both constraints. Here we have the model in Tableau form. For the first constraint, we add the artificial variable A1 and subtract the surplus variable S1 because it's a greater than constraint. And for the second constraint, we add the slack variable S2 since it's a less than constraint. Here we have the initial simplex tableau for the problem. The most positive value in the net evaluation row is 3 plus m, which makes X2 the variable entering the basis. The smallest ratio here is 2, which makes S2 the variable leaving the basis, and 2 here is the pivot element. At the first iteration, we have the following result. Since all the values in the net evaluation row are non-positive, we should have reached an optimal solution. However, the artificial variable A1 is still in the basis, with a positive value 1. Normally, the artificial variable should be eliminated by the time we reach an optimal solution, but it's still there with a positive value. Therefore, we have an infeasible solution. In essence, infeasibility occurs when an artificial variable is positive in the final solution. If the value of the artificial variable is 0, then it can be discarded and we have a solution. However, with a positive value as we have here, the solution is infeasible. Next, we discuss alternative or multiple optimal solutions case. Note here that the objective function is parallel to the second constraint line. So if we move the objective function line, it will coincide with the second constraint line, and every point in that overlap within the feasible region will be an optimal solution point. In essence, we have an infinite number of optimal solutions to the problem. The Tableau form of the model here shows a slack variable for each constraint. And here we have it in its initial simplex tableau. The largest positive value in the net evaluation row is 4, indicating that X1 will be entering the basis. And the smallest ratio is 2, indicating that S2 should be removed from the basis. That is, the pivot element is 2. At the first iteration, we reach an optimal solution, as there are no positive values in the net evaluation row. The solution is x1 equals 2, x2 equals 0, s1 equals 6, and s2 equals 0, with an objective function value z of 8. Now note that x2 is not in the basis and has a 0 value in the net evaluation row. This is an indication that we may have alternative optimal solutions. Recall that the net evaluation entry for a variable represents the net change in the objective function value if one unit of the variable is introduced into the solution. In essence, since x2 is 0 in the net evaluation row, we can introduce it into the solution without changing the objective function value 8. Replacing s1 with x2 here gives another solution point, x1 equals 1.25 and x2 equals 1.5. but with the same objective function value 8. Therefore, we can know that alternative optimal solutions exist if a non-basic variable has a 0 net evaluation row value. Next, we discuss unboundedness. Since this is a maximization problem and we can increase the objective function value indefinitely, we say we have a situation called unboundedness. Here is the problem in Tableau form, and we have the initial simplex tableau here. The largest net evaluation entry suggests x2 should be entering the basis. The ratio here will be negative, which is not allowed, but we have a positive ratio here indicating that A1 will be leaving the basis, so that 2 here is the pivot element. At the first iteration, we have the following result. In the net evaluation row, the only positive entry is 3 over 2. Suggesting that S2 should enter the basis next. But none of the variables could leave the basis because the column values are all non-positive. Hence, we have an unbounded problem. In essence, S2 can increase indefinitely without violating any constraint. Consequently, the objective function can increase indefinitely as well. From the Tableau perspective, unboundedness occurs when we must introduce a variable that has no positive entry in its column. Finally, we discuss degeneracy. An LP model is degenerate if it has a basic feasible solution where at least one basic variable is equal to zero. Consider this LP model. On constructing the graph, we see that the optimal solution occurs here at 2, 0. That is, x2 equals 0 at optimal solution. Now, here's the Tableau form with a slack variable added for each constraint. And here is the initial simplex Tableau. Since 6 is the largest positive value in the net evaluation row, the entering variable is x1. The ratios, however, are tied at 2. That is, we can arbitrarily choose either s1 or s2 to leave the basis. This tie in the minimum ratios is an indication that we have degeneracy. Suppose we choose s1 as the leaving variable. Then at the first iteration, we have the following. The net evaluation row has no positive value, indicating that we have an optimal solution, which is x1 equals 2 and s2, a basic variable, equals 0. Thus, we have a degenerate solution. And we can tell in the Tableau by either obtaining tied ratios or by having a basic variable equals 0 at optimal solution. Now, let's examine a few simplex Tableaus and determine which of the special cases exist in them. Problem 1. You can pause the video and determine which situation exists here. We see here that there are no positive values in the net evaluation row, so we have the final Tableau. However, the artificial variable A1 is still basic with a positive value 2. Therefore, the situation here is infeasibility. And here is the model that results in the final Tableau. Problem 2. Here we do not have the final Tableau, as x2 should enter the basis next. But if we try to determine the variable leaving the basis, we find that the ratios are tied, which indicates we will have a degenerate solution in the next iteration. Therefore, the condition here is degeneracy. Problem 3. In this Tableau, the only positive value in the net evaluation row is 5, which means S1 should enter the basis next. However, none of its column values is positive, which indicates we have unboundedness. In essence, S1 can increase indefinitely without violating any of the constraints. Problem 4. Here we have the final Tableau and a basic variable S2 equals 0. Therefore, this is degeneracy. The result here is the next iteration of the Tableau we found in problem 2. Problem 5. This is a final Tableau since all the entries are non-positive in the net evaluation row. Note, however, that S1 is non-basic, but has a zero value in the net evaluation row. This indicates that we have alternative optimal solutions, since S1 can enter the basis without changing the objective function value. We have the current solution here with an objective function value of 8. Now, suppose we decide to replace X1 with S1 in the basis. That produces a new solution with the same objective function value 8. Indicating that this is an alternative optimal solution. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.